Find out more about VITURE and CD Projekt Red's Cyberpunk Limited Edition XR glasses by the end of this video. VITURE Luma Ultra, their enterprise-level XR solution that I'm currently wearing. And before I tell you about them, allow me to lay the foundations of why and how this video will help differentiate them versus other Luma products. As I first experienced VITURE products with their Pro XR over a year ago, I was taken aback by how good the product was, but still not without cons. One in particular was a con that not only belongs to VITURE, but to XR in general, that consumer tech always comes with a great level of user input, be it through a keyboard, a mouse, a controller, a touchscreen, etc. XR glasses are amazing, but in many use cases, they limit that notion. While we've seen ways to remedy that issue, it usually requires external options such as a controller or else. Well, the Luma Ultras are specifically designed to help combat that issue, and this video will explore why, but also if it's worth for regular users like you and I. Now, usually, tech videos starts with specs, and you should see them on screen. Feel free to pause for details. The Luma Pro and Ultra are in many ways extremely close to one another, in look, in performance, and how the overall experience translates. There are a few differences, five in particular. The first is brightness. The Ultra are 50% brighter than the Pro. Second, the Ultra has three cameras, two on the sides for hand tracking and one RGB in the middle. The middle one is also on the Pro model. Third, when paired with some software and hardware, the Ultra can achieve 6DOF, a direct result to the increased cameras, whereas the Pro is limited to 3DOF, at least at this point in time. A quick annotation to simplify what 3 versus 6 degrees of freedom mean: 3DOF is like saying you can only move on this piece of paper, and this piece of paper is flat. Depth in itself is not captured. 6DOF makes it that your movement can now be captured inside of a cube. Depth are introduced. Fourth difference is price. Luma Pros starts at $499, whereas the Ultra starts at $599. And last, the one difference we won't really talk about in this video, the Ultra have a microphone on the body, whereas the Pro does not. That leaves a lot that are the same. The diopter dials, the display, the optics, the magnetic connector, the in-glasses audio, even the aesthetics. The included carry case looks identical on both. Now, the other thing we'll talk about in this video is the Pro Neckband. Probably the best accessory to showcase the difference between the two products. The Pro Neckband comes in two flavors, and much like the glasses, I'll put the specs on screen. Feel free to pause if needed. What this contraption is a wearable battery-powered Google TV. There's definitely more under the hood than just that, as VITURE packs this thing with a proprietary interface to address the very con that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, user input. You see, at one of the ends of this neckband is a camera that can, similar to a Quest headset or a Vision Pro, capture your hands to achieve and tracking to navigate your UI. I want to thank VITURE for the hardware you'll see in this video, sent for the purpose of this review. No money changed hands, and all opinions are my own, the pros just as the cons. Now, this is not the only hardware that can take advantage of the Ultra's improvements. Phones, laptops, and potentially more down the road could also benefit, but if we're talking about the VITURE ecosystem, the Neckband Pro is, at least at this point in time, the best way to illustrate and experience those changes. And with this introduction now behind us, let's move to chapter 2 of 4, the glasses. Maybe to the surprise of some, the chapter will be quite fast, not because the product is not worthy of a lengthy chapter, but rather because this product, at least on the surface, is so similar to the Pro that it effectively is pointless for me to spend another 10 minutes rehashing what is 90% of what you can find on this review that I covered of the Luma Pro. If you're looking to find out if the Ultras are for you, bookmark that video and watch it next. I'll tell you 90% of what you can expect. The other 10% I'll cover in this video, starting with brightness. And here's why I don't think it'll have a big impact. Every VITURE glasses have electrochromic film. You probably won't need to crank the brightness up. This feature lets you create this dark enclosed environment, even in broad daylight, for colors and brightness to come through. Think wearing shades that are so tinted that you'd feel like you're in a near pitch black basement. Using an optional accessory such as this one, you can also add blinds to prevent a lot of light leakage. So while the extra 500 nits for a total of 1500 is nice versus 1000 on the Luma Pro, I like to think that it's more for flexibility than it is to be used. But like my friend Alex at Too Loud Tech often says, he likes to burn his retina, so I'm sure some will appreciate the added nits. It feels the same from one pair to the other. Moving on to chapter 3, and we're going to talk about what happens when you plug this to a Neckband Pro, but before we do, VITURE has a SDK on their website. That SDK does not seem to support the Luma series yet, but I do believe that this will be a greater differentiator between the two when it does. Case in point, another good friend, Aiden Walls, made a video using the Pro XR on his Steam Deck, another good one to bookmark, and I'll tell you why. What Aiden does in his video goes beyond using the XR glasses for a regular viewing experience. In fact, what Aiden does using the Decky Loader plugin on the Steam Deck is more akin to what a VR headset feels like, at least partially. Partially why? Because Pro XR only supports 3DOF, but VR is 6DOF, something that the Luma Pro couldn't, but the Ultra could. And the one place where you can experience that today is with the Pro Neckband. I hope this helps illustrate the difference that the Enterprise Edition unlocks, be it now or down the road. Using the Pro Neckband is very much like using a Google TV, except when thinking of the launcher. The launcher being that front page where you launch applications has more of an Apple Vision Pro look, and the Ultra, if my head goes forward and backward, the icons stay still in space. Now, I mentioned earlier that 6DOF enables moving inside of a cube. That cube is nowhere near as big as what you'd have on an Apple Vision Pro, for example, meaning that if I try to leave my icons in the living room and move to my kitchen, I won't suddenly find the icons all the way back. They'll follow me after a certain distance. I couldn't tell you if it's by design or a limitation, but my educated guess would be that it's probably a bit of both. We're not talking about the same level of computational power as Apple's headset. The Luma Ultra needs to be assisted by the external device, the Neckband Pro for instance, whereas their upcoming Beast should have some processing power in the glasses themselves, allowing you to anchor your image in space similar to what is found in one competitor's brand. Effectively, what Aiden Walls experienced in a Steam Deck video is no different. The Steam Deck, in that specific instance, was the computational power that created that more convincing effect, but that was still assisted by the 3DOF sensor found in the Pro XR. But there was a major issue, drift. On the Pro XR, you had a bunch of cool 3DOF things you could do, especially when paired with a MacBook. But as much as the software was amazing, the glasses would often drift, and that still happens on the Luma Pro, but way less. And this also still happens on the Luma Ultra, but also less than the more cost-efficient Lumas. For the record, the Luma Pro should receive 6DOF support down the road, but it'll achieve that with one camera and sensors, whereas the Ultra has three cameras and sensors, which is what explains the fact that there is less drift, but software isn't mature enough yet to be able to say that you won't have any at all. Still, I found it to be much, much, much better on the Ultra. Also, for those being worried, the image drift only occurs when using software to achieve that effect. If we're talking about using the glasses like a screen, it'll never drift. I'm not one to recommend buying tech on the premise of what it could achieve down the road, but that doesn't mean I won't say what we could expect, being that VITURE is ahead of any other competitor when it comes to software. I truly believe it is fair to expect that VITURE will eventually update their SDK when they feel like they pushed their foundation to where they want to be, and when they do, that means that developers will be able to build their own codes on top of that SDK, like we've seen with the Steam Deck. Back to the Pro Neckband. Here's where I think it's important to lean on the fact that VITURE presents the Ultras as an enterprise solution, and what I hear is, this is not immediately beneficial to end users like you and I. That's as honest as I can be, and I know this is not the conclusion yet, but buying the Ultra for the benefits it has could potentially fall flat, especially if that $100 difference is meaningful. If it's not, and you want to future-proof yourself, it's an easy decision, go for the Ultras, but if not, the difference is probably not gonna be worth. And to get the best out of that difference, You'll also have to dish out another couple of hundreds for the Neckband Pro, and if you do, what you get today is better than software running on phones. The most obvious one is hand tracking. Indeed, the Pro Neckband tracks your hands to click stuff by touching your thumb and index in a pinching motion, and you can move in space to select stuff and whatnot. Is it cool? Yes. Would you rapidly trade this solution for a remote control? Also, yes, but that could be a me thing. The best hand tracking I've ever seen is with the Vision Pro, and granted, it works well, but even there, I felt like I often needed physical inputs. Then there is the Quest VR headsets from Meta. That too has pretty convincing hand tracking, but as much as they have improved it over the years, it still feels clunky at times, and VITURE's hand tracking is nowhere near being as reliable or intuitive or viable as even what the Quest headsets possess. It's amazing that we're moving in that direction where we don't need those physical inputs, and I can't think of a better brand right now than VITURE in the XR space when it comes to software. I'm sure they'll get there. A statement backed by having seen nearly a year of software updates on the Pro Neckband, and let me tell you, it gets better every update they put out. But it's not the only software they have. Their UI is called Spacewalker, and inside of Spacewalker is also Immersive 3D. If you never tried XR glasses, you might not be aware that you can do half side-by-side 3D with them. And to achieve that 3D movie effect where you see depth, it requires a left image and right image. Well, much like 3D TVs that had a turn any movie 3D mode, Immersive 3D is VITURE's own software-based algorithm to make any video you watch become 3D. It's definitely better than the nothing burger that TV manufacturers used to give us, but much like what you hear reviewers of the Absolute 3D One handheld say, those who know, know, the fake quote-unquote 3D can sometimes work amazingly well, just like it can sometimes make mistakes. For example, in this sample video, I see like a crown of hair that are completely at the wrong depth above this guy's head. But the rest of the scene is elevated, which is what a somewhat convincing effect. And much like everything we talked about with degrees of freedom, Immersive 3D is definitely a proof of concept that keeps on improving every time they give us an update. But much like the hand tracking, it's still a work in progress. And that's why I have the utmost respect for VITURE to have called the Ultra an enterprise solution. And for the fourth and last chapter of this review, my conclusion is the Ultra remains an excellent pair of XR glasses, and to this day, the best that has been produced by VITURE. The great news is the benefits that the Ultra have over the Luma Pros will not require you to sacrifice something beyond $100, that is. Instead, you have more to look forward to with the Ultra, but this is very much the pair that is designed for those who want to show a greater level of support because they want the brand to continue to push the ceiling of what the XR space is capable of. And that's the Enterprise Edition, a product that enables you to speak with your wallet. I want VITURE to keep improving in those areas, and in exchange, VITURE will give you improved hardware that you might enjoy in some cases. The good news is, everything else makes the VITURE Luma Ultras of great quality. And if the Luma Pro are the ones you're interested in, as of today, VITURE and CD Projekt RED are entering a brand new collaboration on the Cyberpunk 2077 Luma Pro XR glasses. Specially crafted to celebrate the game's 5-year anniversary, with only 10,000 units to ever be produced, you might want to grab a pair of these, and to know what to expect from those glasses, check my review, link in the description. Let me know in the comments if you'd be interested in an updated review using the Cyberpunk 2077 Limited Edition Luma Pro XR glasses. And that is all for me for today. I hope this helped your journey in deciding what the best XR glasses are for you. If you have questions, you know what to do. Consider hitting the like, and to tune into my other tech deep dives, make sure to subscribe with the bell. I'm Clef. Thank you to VITURE for sending these review units, and thank you for watching. Peace.